Well, all right, folks. Glad you can join me. Thank you so much for your support, and hopefully this is some kind of asset to you, whether actually in the physical sense, or watching this stuff will definitely enhance the physical part of your mental, believe it or not, and I believe in stuff like that, right? So if you take a look at the how-to, or you've been following the how-to stuff, you should have enough to follow all of these drills, all right? Definitely to work on them and start. So I at least want to give us enough so that we can train our army, so that we can train ourselves, and so this could be a compliment and extra added stuff to all the other great videos that are out there. All right, so we're gonna do start this one. This is just the basic drills sessions. It's just a basic workout. You're joining me for a nice basic workout. We're gonna start with some hand techniques. We're gonna start with the jab here, and then we're gonna incorporate the front kick in here. I don't need you to be great at all the kicks and stuff, but in a self-defense way and great for exercises and stuff, definitely get the front kick in there. All right, so you're already warmed up. Say hi to Lockie, my cattle dog. Okay, so we're gonna do the jab, and I'm showing you some jab stuff here. And there's already lots of the how-to, there's already the drills and stuff that we worked on, but what I'm demonstrating here is how you can throw the jab by your footwork remaining in your sparring stance and your position, by stepping into it a little bit, and also by bending it, by bending your lead leg, combinations of it, by bending your lead leg, but also by bending your rear leg, and combinations of those are going to give you certain kinds of extensions and reaches. So play with those, and they're also going to give you little variations in how you're able to throw your punch, whether you want to throw a straight, stiff jab, or when you want to snap, and whether you know, stuff like that. So yeah, so that's what I'm showing you here. And in particular, what I'm doing is a little bit more of the step, a little bit more of that sort of snapping thrust forward, but also that step forward. You could do a really great deep step in if you want, and you're going to have to retreat and draw that back after, most likely, or you can kind of bring your rear forward, and that kind of would bring you into an advancing one, all right? So you're here with me, and I'm going to talk you through this and stuff, so that even if you can't watch the whole thing and you have it playing while you're practicing, you could at least hear my voice and stuff. So now we're moving to the 1-2 and versions of that. You don't have to be precise here in the sense of following exactly what I'm doing, but we're working together, and we're feeding off each other and motivating each other. So the point here is you're throwing a jab, and then you're going to throw that cross, all right, the 1-2. Play around with it. Playing around with it means that you're moving around and stuff. I've given you the slips and the dips and the weave, so that you can also get that body motion, that head motion involved as well. And so double jab and the cross, right? Double jab and your power shot. In your rotations of your shoulder and your body language, that can get you the driving force to drive straight your cross, or snap that cross, all right? A great way to snap that cross is to pop it and then bring it back. Bring it right back. Don't leave it out there. Don't take your merry time bringing it back. You know, pop it. Rotations will help you get that snap. And here I'm exaggerating that rotation. One way to exaggerate that rotation is find your center line and then kind of be at 45, or even worse, be at like 90 degrees from your center line, but then rotate and punch to your center line. Okay, and that's going to force your body to rotate and twist into that. See what I'm doing? And that's going to help you get that snap. That's also going to help you prevent you from squaring up too much. At least squaring up is a bad habit, which means that you're increasing the amount of exposed area and to your opponent and stuff. All right. So basics, right? So we're doing the jab. We did the jab, double jab, and cross. We're moving around while we're doing it, right? Circular motions, not just straight back and forward. There's nothing wrong with going straight back and forward. And now we're going to do some of our dips and slips and weaves as well. And you can do that because I did the how-to videos on that. If you haven't seen those how-to videos, but you're in this video right now, no worries. Just watch what I'm doing now, but also just follow your body motion and stuff. Just visualize is one of the most important things. I don't want you to draw a complete blank. Not yet. There are times when you can enjoy your workout in a meditative sense and just, you know, sort of be kicking it to the oldies in the music. Here I want you to visualize it. So if you're throwing a punch, I want you to visualize getting out of the way. So flinching also when a punch is being thrown at you, and then I want you to observe and feel your body motion and what it's trying to do when it gets out of the way or when it flinches, and that's going to tell you, okay, what your sort of your natural range of your dipping and slips are and stuff, okay? And then of course you expand on that by playing around with it and modifying and tweaking it and exaggerating it or trying to get away with as little as possible as well, not always an exaggerated dedicated move. All right, man, moving along, right? Hopefully you're having a great time, right? These are just some of your definitely basic day of practice and even grateful warm-up for those advanced guys. We're throwing a front kick in here. And today's and this round of our drills and workout session will involve all the punching and the front kick. And so Like usual, when you're first starting out or you're just incorporating a kick into the drill, I want you to do the rear kick because the body motion is a little bit easier to start that kick from the back and drive it through and stuff. It's probably a little bit more difficult to do the instant from any type of stance and stuff, because you just got to bring it right back up, and that takes a lot of effort out of you to try to get that leverage and momentum without there being a traditional leverage and momentum happening. So what am I doing here? So we're doing the jab or the double jab and then the cross. So the one, two. And then we're doing the rear front kick, and we're bringing that rear front kick down in front of us into a new stance. And then we're going to do the same thing in that new stance. And we're going to keep going, and that's classic drill. We've done this drill before, and this is just an ordinary, regular, and in no disrespectful way, this is an ordinary, regular, really cool workout that we're starting. And this is one of your drills that you should probably always have in there, which is, you know, your 1-2 or 1-1-2 double jab, and then rear front kick. Remember, keep in mind those 1-1-2s, they can be low, high, high, low, high, high, and all combinations of that. Don't just go always to the head, mix and match it from the body to the head and stuff. Your front kick is the same way. It doesn't have to be as high as me. It doesn't always have to be at the head. It could also be mid to the chest, solar plexus, and also could be lower to the guts, and even lower, the pelvis area, and then even lower, okay, to somebody's knee and stuff like that. So here, let's take a step back now and practice some stuff, guys, right? I want you to understand the ergonomics, the flow, the rhythm, and the movement here. So I want you to see how the punch drags and carries your body with it through the motion. And then I want you to feel and I want you to think about what kicks you can pack, you can load on top of that motion that you're generating from the punch. It's a very natural, fantastic camouflage and disguise and stuff. So there are some people who are disciples of the idea that you should never just throw a kick straight out against your opponent. You should always mask it with something. Don't just throw a kick. That's not entirely wrong. And that's pretty good in the sense that a kick can be a very large, massive movement. So against somebody who's anticipating it, who's got a really good read on you, okay, it might be easy to see or feel or react to or tell that you're launching a kick. So you might want to mask it a little bit. Or regardless of any of that theory that I just said, it's great to have in your repertoire kicks that you can throw right as an instant without any masking, and then ones that you can mask. And one great way of masking it without being overly complicated is to start by throwing some punches at your opponent and then finish that off with the kick. Cool? All right. So what do we got going on here now? All right, I'm going low and then high. To the gut. Get out of the way. Go high. Okay, I remember this. What we're doing here is I want you to take some extra advantages of some other things that are your body language and your motion has evolved. And to make a long story short, what I'm suggesting here is after you're doing your dip on the rise up, and it doesn't have to be a complete rise up, but on that rise up, notice that? I want you to use that motion upwards to ride a punch through that. And later on, I'm going to show you and I'm going to help you work through riding a kick through that. Not late necessarily later on through here, I don't think, because that's a complicated, difficult move to do. Okay? But you should be able to see what I'm doing here. So I want you to throw a punch, throw your jab, get out of the way by dipping, okay? And then from the dipped position, I want you to re-straighten up or rise or at least come forward, okay? And ride that momentum with your next set of punches. And that's what you're seeing here. See, here you're seeing a very realistic version. Not very exaggerated. It's not like I need you to rise up or whatever, but you're just seeing how after I dip, I'm throwing the punches on the come back up, or on the straightening up, or moving to the back to my, you know, core stances and stuff. Mix and match the thrusting of your front kicks. They don't always have to be snaps. They don't always have to be high. They can be thrusting, lunging ones as well. Thrusting front kicks are fantastic. They can do damage like a snapping snap kick, a snapping front kick a little bit, but they could also defend and stall your opponent and push your opponent and what's that word I'm looking for there? Deny or resist or repel your opponent from any of their advances and stuff. And I don't think we're going to do heaps more variations and stuff. I've talked pretty furiously, I think, but that's because I'm kind of trying to narrate straight as I see it, so I don't have to do a tremendous amount of edits, taking my words and bringing them back to the actual footage and stuff. But yeah, like I said in the beginning, all of this session right now is going to be our front kick, and we're just doing a whole bunch of punches and with the front kick, classic, right? All right, so love you very much, and catch me in the next one. We're going to do a couple of fight workouts together, and then I'll upload some new workouts I've been doing at some other places, and I've been getting some grappling with trees in there as well. Miss those guys and don't want to completely neglect that.